students, here Himali Shah. Today we are going to learn about the Java program structure, right? As we know, in C++ we have also used classes, okay? Then classes contains a data members and methods, right? So that operate the data members of the data class, right? Methods may contain the data type declaration and executable statement. To write a Java program, we have to first define the classes. And then put them into the header. So Java program may contain a one or more section, right? This is the structure of Java program. First, that is the documentation section. Documentation section, it comprises a set of comments. Comments must explain why and what of the classes and how of the algorithms. This would be greatly help to maintain the program. There are two styles of the comment. As we discussed earlier, Java also use this third style of comment, that is the documentation comment. See, first, that is the single line comment. This is used for the multi-line comments and this is used for documentation comment. So this form of comment is used for the generating documentation automatically. Comment section we are using, like I am writing the program of find the square of number. So I have to mention over there okay, which program is this. So I can use comment over there, right? For the single line comment, double slash, slash star to star slash for the multi-line comment, slash star star to star slash documentation section. This two type of section we have already seen in C++. And this is the new style in Java, documentation section. Next, that is the package statement. The first statement allow in a Java file is a package statement. It's a package statement. And yes, this statement declares the package name. Like package, package name. This is the syntax of declaration of package. Package statement, that is the optional. This is the optional, right? And documentation section, that is also optional. Next, import statement. The next thing after the package statement may be a number of import statement. This is the similar to hash include. Hash include statement. We have already seen in C++ hash include std.h, hash include conio.h. So we are importing the header file in our program. In place of that, in Java we have to write import statement like import java dot lang dot math. If we are doing the mathematical operation in the program, then we have to import the math, lang dot math. There are so many import statements we can use. There are different types of the import statement. So this instruct the import java dot lang dot math. Math is used for the mathematical operations. Like we have discussed, if I want to find the square of any number, okay, then I have to import the java dot lang dot math. Using import statement, we can have access to classes that are part of name in the program, name of the package. Next, interface statement. This is also optional, we can say. But when we are using something mathematical operation and so on, then we have to write like import. Next, interface statement. Interface is like a class but include a group of method declaration. Interface. Okay. This is also optional section. This is also optional section. Used in when we wish to implement a multiple inheritance. We have seen in C++, C++ support the multiple inheritance by default. But when we are writing the program of multiple inheritance in Java, then we have to use the interface. Without interface, we cannot write the multiple inheritance. Interface is a new concept in Java. We can study later. This is the use of interface. Next, class definition. Java program may contain a multiple class definition. You can contain a multiple class in a single program. Classes are primary and essential element of a Java program. These classes are used to map objects of a real world problem. The number of classes used to depends on the complexity of problem. So So syntax of class, like class space class name. Next, main method. Main method, since every Java standalone program requires a main method. In Java program, if we want to reach the starting of the compilation, then how could the machine know where I have to start the program? Then this is the main method. From the main method, it will execute the program. Classes an essential part of Java program. Main method is that is the essential part of a Java program. Simple Java program may contain only this part. Only this part. The main method creates object of various classes and establishes the communication between them. On reaching of the main method, the program terminates and the control passes back to the operating system. We are writing in program like public static void main. Main, that is the method. Or we can consider a main that is a function like in C and C++. Every Java application program must include a main method. This is the starting point. You can say this is the starting point of Java program. So interpreter begins its execution of program. Java application can have any number of classes, but one class contains the main method for the initial the execution as unprotected and therefore making it accessible to all other classes. This is similar to the C++ public modifier. We have already used in C++ public modifier to access the another classes, same as it is. Next, static. Next appear the keyword static. We declare this method as a one that belongs to the entire class and not a part of any object of a class. The main must always declare as a static, since the interpreter uses this method before any objects are created. More about the static method and variables we will discuss later. Next, void. Void means nothing written. This type of the modifier states that main method doesn't return a value. So this is about a public static void main. Next, we are using in C++ cout to print a value. Print a statement, we can say. For that, in Java, we are using system.out.println. System.out.println and whatever you want to print, then semicolon. This is similar to the printf. This is similar to the cout. In C++, printf in C. since Java is a true object-oriented programming language, which is a static data member of a system class. println, that is the static data member of a system class. println, that is the method of println, that is a method, and out, that is the object, which is a static data member of a system class. So this is all about system.out.println. If I want to print a hello, then what I have to write? System.out.println. System.out.println, then hello. Then it will show hello. This is like a printf. System.out.println, that is like printf and cout. So this is about the Java program structure. Now method println always append a new line character to the end of the string. This means that any subsequent output will start on a new line. Not the semicolon at the end of the statement, that is necessary. At the end of statement, we have to write semicolon. Every Java statement must end with a semicolon. So now we are going to see how to write a simple program. So this is about the Java program. Class name. This program you have to write in Notepad or Notepad++. C class C1, that is your class name. Then curly bracket, public static void main. This is the main statement of your program. Without this statement, you are not able to run your program. Public static void main, string argues. Then next, system.out.println hello. As we discussed, to print any statement, we have to write a hello. System.out.println, then hello. Then curly bracket finished and this finished. For compile the program, we have to use Java C space class name, that is C1. And mind where in program S, that is the capital. S, that is also capital. If you are writing in a lower case, then you will get the error. Mind well. After writing this program, you have to save your program like a c1.java. And mind well, your class name and your file name, that will be same. So you have to save c1.java. For compilation, Java C command is used to run the program. Java C1, Java command is used. After save this program, you have to open the command prompt. Okay. Next, you have to set path. Like C drive, then program files, next Java, JDK, whatever the version you have saved, next Bean. Next, in which folder, in which drive you have saved this program, that you have to write. For example, I have saved this program in D drive prect folder. And what I have to write? D, then enter. So it will come like a D. Now we have to set the folder name and write a cd space prect, then enter. The next you will get like prect. Next, in this folder you have saved your program C1, so you have to write like Java C. This is smaller, Java C C1. Next, this is for the compilation. If you have any error, then you will get the error in compilation mode. Next, for run the program, you have to write like you will get the blinking in this point. So you have to write a Java C1, then enter. You will get the output hello. This is the simple way how to compile and run the Java program.